At the start of a new year, most folks are always looking for a new resolution to do something different. Maybe it's improve themselves. It could be exercise, diet, or learning something new. We're going to help with that third thing today. For people who want to learn something new about Office, we're going to show you some starting points, some places you can begin to learn about something that maybe you've always put off or something brand new that you've that's popped up on your radar that you want to learn about Office. If you're on the live call, we can work with you on the IM windows and show you some of the things. We asked folks in previous webinars what they want to learn, and that's how we'll kick off today's Office 15-minute webinar. One place to start with I want to show you is kind of the mothership for us, which is at office.com. A lot of the content you get inside your Office program, you'll find at office.com. And if you go to the main page, office.com, you want to look for the support tab at the top of your screen. And you can find a lot of great information here. The support tab should be in almost, I would think, around the world. We have almost over 100 sites around the world if you're looking at this internationally. The support tab is there, and you'll find a lot of great information. For the U.S. site, that big picture right there in the middle, the Get Started, that's a great place to start for two different areas. One, if you've just upgraded to the latest version of Office, you want to know what's new in Excel, what's new in Outlook, you can find that information here. Or if you're starting something new for the first time, you're someone's first getting into Excel or Word, you can get basics, quick start guides, video tutorials, all right here in the Get Started. It has a short URL, office.com/get-started, all one word. That information there. For those of you who picked up the new version of Office, maybe you got it under the tree this year, you have things like Access and Publisher available you maybe never have used before. Here's a great place to start, office.com/get-started. One other area here from the support tab I wanted to show you is going down to the free training. We have training for lots of different versions of Office, lots of programs. The top part here with the icons, the 2013 materials for the latest version of Excel, Outlook, even things like SharePoint or Link, things we haven't talked about a lot here at the Office webinar. If you go a little bit lower, if you have an older version of Office, Office 2010, Office 2007, Office for Mac 2011, you can find links right here. And this is a short URL, office.com/training. Try to keep it simple on that. But let's go over to some of the questions that people asked what they wanted to learn about Office, and we'll show you some of those materials here. Ramona and several folks asked us a couple weeks ago, and this seemingly is one of the top topics people get, is they want to learn about pivot tables. One of the reasons I know that I need to learn about pivot tables is I use a pivot table once every few months, and then of course I totally forget how to use a pivot table. There's two links here. All these links will be at our Office blog post. If someone can throw that in the IM window, all these are already there, so you can easily get to them. There's two that I wanted to show you. One is just a very beginning. It's called a quick start. It's three steps of how pivot tables work. Basically, pivot tables are in Excel. You can quickly look at a whole bunch of data and analyze it very quickly. This is a great way to start if you've never done a pivot table before and learn about it. The second one is getting into some things, and we're going to do some webinars in 2014 that deal with the power tools, power view, things that are used for business intelligence, is called, or BI for short. This is a page that has a lot of information of how to create pivot charts and pivot tables if you're trying to get a specific area that you're trying to work on. Both these pages will be linked in the blog. One thing I did want to show in the new version of Excel is that there's an insert pivot table, kind of a wizard that's been around for a couple, at least since 2010. But I want to show you with the new Excel 2013. Here I have a table of data. It's a couple hundred rows. If I go up to the insert in the left-hand corner, and look in the left-hand corner here, you get two buttons. One is that usual pivot table that's been around, but there's now recommended pivot tables. Let's click on that. Actually, let me click on any cell of the table, then click recommended pivot tables. And just like we have with recommended charts, you get kind of a gallery of things. Well, what are you trying to really look at? So it says, are you trying to look for the colors of all these? It looks like I'm a bike shop and I have all these products. No, I really don't want to learn about, it's not really color. Let me click down, and then this is accessories. That's a little better. Let me keep clicking down here. And you can see different ones. Now, here's one. This breaks it down to accessories and subcategories. So that's the one I want. So I just click on that. And then boom, boom. More boom in 2014 webinars. I think that's one of my New Year's resolutions. We have this pivot tables made right there. So I didn't even have to learn how to do a pivot table. I just clicked on the recommended pivot tables, and it's broken apart that data into categories and subcategories and set up the pivot table fields for me on the right-hand side of the screen. Rod asked about access, about switchboards and splash screens. Now, those are terms I did not recognize. I don't know a ton about access, but I know people that do. So switchboards, we found an article for Rod about navigation forms. And again, that's some of the thing is that you, some people call things certain things, some call them others. Over time, terms have changed and things like that. So again, you can find articles like this at office.com. But the other thing I did want to show that I thought was an interesting thing of how office.com works is he was also asking about splash screens. And we have no articles or videos about splash screens at Office. However, office.com is set up that you could that we bring up results that will bring that kind of information to you. So if you type in splash screen for Access 2010, it gives you several mostly forums that you can go to that have information. One I wanted to show you here is this answers.microsoft.com. That's the official Microsoft forum. And many people troll that area, Microsoft MVPs, these are people who are designated experts in the area. They don't work for Microsoft, but they are experts with Microsoft technology. So here was the startup screen question, which is synonymous with a splash screen. And, you know, there's a best answer that comes to the top. It's done by an MVP. That's that little blue logo there. But there's a whole chain of conversation back and forth between people and this MVP about start screens and splash screens. So you can find that information, ask your own questions at the Microsoft community, answers.microsoft.com. Okay, let's go on with the countdown. I think I saw Deborah on board. Deborah has asked about OneTastic. OneTastic is an old-fashioned add-in for a Microsoft product. This was actually designed by one of the folks here on the OneNote team, I do believe. It's kind of a side project. It's a way to add functionality to OneNote, and I'll show you what that looks like here. It works for OneNote 2010 or OneNote 2013. And basically, once you download it, it adds to the home toolbar. I'm going to wait for a second for this to render. But if you look at the right-hand side of the screen, that's the OneTastic toolbar. It adds a lot of functionality to OneNote. And you can also make your own, if you want to do your own macros, you can actually work on and develop your own functionality. Here's a couple things that it does. One is the calendar. If you click on this calendar icon, it actually looks at your OneNote by days that you've added pages. So you can go in. So here's this month. I can even go back to 2010, January, and I can link and I can see all these. Now I can search in OneNote very easily, but if I, yes, back on January 10th, I looked at a pork stew from Peru. Peruvian. See, that's one thing I didn't practice in rehearsal. So you can find all of your information by a calendar if you want to. Other things this does is you can put pins to the desktop automatically. You can add content. You can clean up your authors, clean up your hyperlinks, which is sometimes good when you're dealing with old pages. So there's several things that you can do with OneTastic, and you can customize it for your own macros. If there's some wild thing you want to learn about, be able to dig through your OneNote, besides search, you could do it with OneTastic. It's a free download, kind of builds on our webinars we were doing last year of free extra products you can get. So that's for that. There you go, Deborah, OneTastic. A couple people asked, including Sam, asked about the difference between SkyDrive and SkyDrive Pro. SkyDrive is where you can store information in the cloud. Everyone can get a SkyDrive account. It's 7 gigabytes of storage. If you just go to skydrive.com and sign in, if you have a Microsoft ID, which includes Hotmail, Xbox Live, any of that stuff, you sign in, you can use web apps, you can share documents. It's all done online. And that way, if you put a document, if I have a document on one of my computers and I go over to Dave's house and I get on his computer, I go to SkyDrive, I can get that same document right there. It's a great way to store documents across devices. SkyDrive Pro is only if for businesses. If you've signed up with Office 365, you get into a whole SharePoint area, things like that, you can get SkyDrive Pro. And what we think of it here is SkyDrive is for my personal documents. SkyDrive Pro is for my work documents. I can still share them. I can use the web apps. I can even share them with people that aren't in the company. It's just two different areas. It's a what we call a firewall that's between the SkyDrive Pro that is more protected for people in that company. We can talk more about that. I think there's been some questions online. We'll talk about that in our live segment, but let me go back and grab a few more folks over what they were looking for. Kevin was asking about SharePoint. What does SharePoint do and what can you do? Again, it's for businesses that work with it. And you can go to SharePoint.com is a starting point if you're brand new to SkyDrive. Sorry, if you're brand new to SharePoint, you can grab information here about SharePoint Online, get an overview, see some early videos. One thing I did want to show, though, how to learn about that is going back to our support page. I'm going to go to the training area, which is office.com/training, and click on the SharePoint icon. And this is our videos you can download. They're PowerPoint videos you can download. They bring you several things. So if you just want to learn about how to customize a public website, how to introduce document libraries, how the new feeds work, how to share documents, you can watch those videos. But you can also get these quick reference cards. Let me show you what that looks really quick. These are in Word. And you can print them out if you need to. They're formatted to look really nice in a printout. This is like a two-page printout that gives you basic information. So if your team is on SharePoint this year, you want to get a quick reference card of how to share documents and manage versions, you can get that. You can see it has a lot of information and other links of where to get more information. We've done some webinars about SharePoint. You can find those at our homepage, which is aka.ms/offweb. Before we hit to the live calls, last thing, we've had a lot of people talk about these new power tools they're called for Excel, PowerView, BI tools. We're going to do some of that in 2014. Basically, PowerView and PowerMap is a way to look at information that you have in an Excel spreadsheet, and you can do it in a map form. And there's some articles we have here. There's also a whole business intelligence BI section for Microsoft because it's more than just Excel. It's a terminology that really big companies use, but more and more smaller companies are trying to get into what's called this business intelligence BI. They really analyze their data. And I'll leave you with just a little showing. We'll go back to this Excel chart that I use with these bike sales to show you kind of what a PowerView map would look like. This looks at that same data of accessories and then also maps it out so I get a view of where these bike sales are working on, and it's an interactive way to do it. It's sometimes something you really can't bite off in 15 minutes, but we're going to try to do that probably in February. You can find a lot of this information, again, at office.com by searching for it or go to the training area to get information about a lot of these things. But for now, I'm going to wrap up our time and say that all the links we talked about or the ones that we do in the live part of the Q&A that we'll do right now is you can find that at aka.ms/askus123. This video will also be up in a couple days. We will be here for January and February, or we've announced the schedule for January and February. Go to aka.ms/offweb to learn more about the Office 15-minute webinar. Next week, we're going to show you some time savers, some quick time savers that you learn it for a minute. It will save you minutes a day that turn into hours in a week probably to help you learn Office a little quicker. That's next week, but for today's Office webinar team, thank you for joining this Office 15-minute webinar.